This is Catherine Schmer at Chattanooga State Community College. This is Lines in Space Video 1. In this video, we'll talk about the vector equation of a line. So first we want to think about what determines a line. So the standard response that people give me when I ask this is 2 points. So yes, 2 points determine a line, but we could also think about this as a point and a direction. So you're starting off at some point, and then you have some direction to go in. In two dimensions, a line can be determined by a point and a slope. The general equation of a line in R2, so in two dimensions, is y equals mx plus b. This can be parameterized as follows. So we're going to use a parameter t, so we'll say x equals t, so then y equals mt plus b. This is called a parameterization of the line, and t is called the parameter. So that's one way to express a line. In two dimensions, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense to do it this way, but in three dimensions, we'll have to parameterize or use a vector equation to give the equation of a line. In vector form, so now we're going to introduce a vector equation of a line, let R0 equal the vector 0, comma b, and vector v equals 1, comma m, a vector of slope m. This gives a vector definition of the line, so remember we're still in two dimensions. R of t equals R0 plus tv, where t is the parameter and v and R0 are vectors. So I get the vector 0b, that's my R0 vector, plus t times the vector 1m. If I put that together, that gives me the vector t, comma, mt plus b. Because remember, when we're adding vectors, we add the corresponding components of the vectors. So this is the same as the parameterization x equals t and y equals mt plus b. I've just shown you two different ways to express a line in two dimensions, the parametric equations and the vector form. In R3, three dimensions, there is not a way to define the slope of a line, so we need vectors to specify direction. We'll start with a vector equation for the line L through the point P0, and we'll call that point X0, Y0, Z0, and the line is parallel to V. Then the vector equation is R of T equals R0 plus tv. So the same equation that we just defined in two space, but now we have three components, x, y, and z. So R0 is the vector, the standard vector form from the origin to the point, P0, that we were given. So R0 is the vector with components x0, y0, z0. T is the parameter, and v is the direction vector of the line. Here's our first example. It says, find a vector equation of the line through the point 3, negative 5, 2 in the direction of the vector v equals 1, negative 1, 6. So we have the point, and that gives us R0. R0 will be the vector 3, negative 5, 2. So our line, R of t, is equal to vector 3, negative 5, 2, plus t times the vector 1, negative 1, 6. So R0 plus tv. Now sometimes you can actually combine these vectors. So here's our point and our direction and our parameter. Sometimes you can actually combine these vectors by adding corresponding components. So another way to write the equation of our line would be the vector 3 plus t, negative 5 minus t, and 2 plus 6t. So I'm just adding the corresponding components. To find points on the line, you would plug in values for t. So obviously if I plug in a 0, then I end up with my original point, 3, negative 5, 2, which we already knew was on the line. If I plug in a different t value, a non-zero t value, I would find a different point on the line. So I could actually plot my line by choosing different values of t. Example 2 asks us to find a vector equation of the line through the point 0, negative 2, 4 that is perpendicular to both the lines R1 of t equals the vector 8 minus 4t, 7, 2 plus t, and R2 of t equals the vector negative t, 2 plus 3t, 1 plus 9t. So we have these two vectors, and we want to get direction vectors. So V1 for R1 of t, the direction vector is the numbers attached to the t values, so negative 4, 0, and 1. So it's just the coefficients of t. For R2, my direction vector is V2 equals the vector negative 1, 3, 9. So again, just the coefficients of t. To find a perpendicular direction vector, we need to take the cross product of V1 and V2. Remember that the cross product is always perpendicular, or 90 degrees, to both of the vectors that you're crossing. So I set this up in my matrix to take the determinant. IJK is the top row. Direction vector V1 is the second row, negative 4, 0, 1, and direction vector V2 is the third row, negative 1, 3, 9. So I expand along the top row, I times 0 minus 3. If you need a reminder on cross product, watch the videos for section 11.4. That's where we cover the cross product in more detail. Minus, because I have alternating signs, plus, minus, plus. So minus j times negative 36 plus 1, plus k times negative 12 minus 0. So this gives me a direction vector negative 3i plus 35j minus 12k. There's my direction vector for the line that's perpendicular to both the given lines. So now the line that I'm trying to find, I have R of t equals, I'm going to put in the point, 0, negative 2, 4, plus t times my direction vector, negative 3, 35, negative 12, and there's my equation of the line. So remember, it's always the point plus t times the direction vector, and that gives you a vector equation of the line. And then your coefficients of t always give you the direction vector.